Okay, you asked a question about Eskom. But I think you should ask a question about the entire portfolio of SOC, as they call it here, because it represents a fiscal burden. It's a fiscal drain. Normally, when you own an asset, that asset should deliver returns. But in the case of most of the SOE in South Africa, government doesn't get returns. What government gets is liabilities. So I think there's an agenda to process thoroughly and in a comprehensive manner the reform of the SOE portfolio. And Eskom is one of the main and the most important one. And I think we should not take it outside that broader context. And I think it's important to look at it like that. At the same time, I think you need to recognize that you remember the concept in 2008, too big to fail. It's exactly the same thing that you have. An economy, including in particular an economy like the one in South Africa, cannot afford to have Eskom as a failed entity. So what government has to do is to work with the management and the leadership of Eskom to figure out a way forward. And the way forward entails different kind of intervention. There's a debt restructuring dimension to it, because government has extended some guarantees. And if Eskom cannot pay, government will have to pay. I mean, that's how it works. That's what you call contingent liabilities. At the same time, the company itself has to become more efficient. There's something that we don't usually talk about. When you look at Eskom going to the regulator and asking for tariff increase, why the regulator is always reluctant to educate? Because the regulator also wants to signal that the company has to become more efficient. And this is the second agenda that Eskom has to go through. And that efficiency agenda entails a lot of implication, including if you have overstaffing, it might mean at some point that some staff might be retrenched. So all these considerations have to be put together when you take a decision and when you review a situation like the one Eskom is going through. So our engagement and what the government is doing is to really deal with all these issues. You cannot just deal with one segment and overlook the rest. And I think that's part of a debate, and I think the debate that's taking place now is really going in the right direction, because all the considerations are being really looked into, including restructuring the power sector market. I mean, having Eskom as the most integrated, dominant provider of power is something that is an asset for South Africa, has been an asset for South Africa. But if you want it to remain an asset for South Africa going forward, you also need to pay attention to the transition to clean energy, which is happening at the same time. So reorganizing that market is critically important, and making sure that each part of that market plays its role is critically important. Eskom owes money to banks, but municipality also owes money to Eskom. So all of that has to be looked into seriously, and that's the reason why I want to bring it back as a comprehensive treatment. It should not be looked at as only one factor of it. You should look at the whole agenda, and I think the government is considering a reform agenda for Eskom.